everybody, it's Jeff Williams with Fle Fly, and today I want to take you through a step-by-step process of how I built my LIVESCOPE portable box. I've posted a couple videos using LIVESCOPE, and folks have seen this, and I did a previous video on our YouTube channel about this, but there's a lot of things that I didn't go over and I didn't cover. And there were some details there that I left out that people asked questions about. So we've had a rough day, a rough couple days here in Oklahoma. It's about 22 degrees right now. I'm not out on the lake fishing. And I thought, you know, this would be a perfect time to go over this stuff. And I am gonna go out and I'm gonna show you how I use the magnet system on my boat for my transducer. And I'm gonna show you why I rigged that up the way I rigged it up. But first of all, I want to show you how I got started, okay? Now, I kind of went about this a little bit ass backwards. I ordered a Garmin ice fishing bundle that had the Panoptix live view and forward view. Live view down, live view forward. And after I got it, I realized that I liked the LIVESCOPE technology better than I did the Panoptix technology. Now, LIVESCOPE is somewhat Panoptix. They call it a Panoptix LIVESCOPE, but there's definitely two different technologies. There's a Panoptix live view and down view, and then there's a Panoptix LIVESCOPE. So for Christmas, I ordered the Garmin Panoptix ice fishing bundle. It came with a 74 CV plus Echo Map unit. That's what came in there. This unit also came with this monstrous battery, which makes the ice fishing bundle to me pretty heavy. That is a whopper right there. I don't know how much that thing weighs, but it weighs a lot. So anyway, over the course of time of using this on the docks and then trying to use it out in my boat, I realized that I needed to make something more mobile and lighter, something that I could take tackle with me on to the dock. Because a lot of times when a dock angler has to walk down to a dock, he's gonna be taking this, then he'll have to take a tackle box, then he'll have to take a bucket, and then he'll have to take a fishing rod, and he'll have to take all this stuff. Well, now I just carry this down there, I carry my rod in one hand, and I carry a bucket for my crappie. So I've got everything I needed here. But this is how I kind of integrated the Panoptix ice fishing bundle into what I currently have. Now, one of some of the details I want to go over with you while I have you here so I don't forget. Again, this is a 74 CV Echo Map Plus. These are around $400, around $399 right now online. You can also get a 93 SV, which is around $600 online, that works with the LIVESCOPE system. The LIVESCOPE, Panoptix LIVESCOPE system is about $1,500 is what you're going to end up having to buy. So you're going to have to buy a monitor, which is a fish finder that comes with like down scan, side scan, 2D sonar, and you can hook that up to a LIVESCOPE transducer system. Okay, so some of the other things that I want to show you that I did, and I'm gonna go into getting how I built all this too, but I also bought a Dakota Lithium 12 volt 10Ah battery. Okay, I bought that off Amazon. It was about $120 shipped. Now this battery is running the LIVESCOPE box, the GLS-10 box, and my unit. I'm running that for over 10 hours on this one battery right here. It'll run it a lot longer than it'll run both. This battery will run both of those units. So anyway, I went ahead and put one in here. It weighs a whole lot less than that big lead acid battery, okay? This was an upgrade that I did. This did not come with the ice fishing bundle, but you can buy those. Okay? So, that's what I did for my battery. Now I want to talk a little bit about how I built my pole. Okay? So, the GLS 10 box comes with the LIVESCOPE transducer right here. Okay? All right. So, I pretty simply just taped up my transducer wire to my pole. And by the way, this pole is 5 foot long. It is Schedule 40 PVC 1-inch. 1-inch Schedule 40 PVC. Hey, get up there. And I put a little T-handle on it. So I put a T-handle on it so I would know in relation to which way I've got my transducer facing. Now I'm gonna go and I'm gonna show you how I use this in my boat. But when I use this on a fishing dock, a lot of times a dock has got steel support structure around the bottom of it. So I put a magnet on here to stick to that steel support structure. I also have my magnet set up exactly parallel with my T-handle. So if I want to put this down in the water, I can line this up with my T-handle and line this up with my magnet. I can stick it on a dock, and then I will fish out in the water, and I use it on down view, and the transducer shines like this. Okay, so for whatever reason, if I wanted to use it on forward view, I could flip this around, and I would know exactly where I am aiming this on forward view. So the T-handle is kind of important. It's a reference point for you. Okay, because a lot of times you won't be able to see exactly where the magnet is. Now, there's also times when I move this, okay? Now, when it comes to LIVESCOPE technology, a lot of people like to be able to put it on forward view, and they like to be able to rotate it, or they like to be able to move their pole so they can scan in the water, or they can scan underneath a dock, or they can scan over a brush pile. Okay, so, and that's good. That's the way that I recommend doing it. I didn't really like having my transducer on a trolling motor, where my trolling motor was constantly working to try to hold me in position. I wanted a standard view that never changed unless I changed it, okay? So keep in mind that LIVESCOPE is not a round cone like 2D sonar. You gotta think about this because it's a little bit of a mind warp. This transducer shoots out more like a board, okay? It's long and flat. So when you turn it, it's shooting out looking like this. And the cone is pretty narrow. It's not a round cone like 2D sonar. It's moving like this. Or if it's on down view, it's looking forward and backwards like this. Okay? So that's really important because with old 2D sonar, when you would come up on a fish or a brush pile, if it was anywhere in the cone, it showed it. But you never knew where it was at. With LIVESCOPE, if you have it and you're scanning it, and you see a fish right there, you know exactly on the screen how far the fish is away from where you are because the transducer's cone is long and flat. It's not round. It's a big, big deal. It's a huge deal. And you need to understand why LIVESCOPE is so efficient. So we're going to go back out in the boat and we're going to talk about how I put this together. But again, my pole is 5 foot long. I'm 2 foot from here to here. I just taped my wires up there. I used an old magnet that I've had for 30 years, and I built a couple angle brackets to offset my magnet back to the boat or back to the dock. And this is a fixed position right here. Now, when I go out in my boat, I can also, because it's a magnet, I can also rotate my pole forward or backward to get the best picture out of my boat. And I can turn this any way I want it And I can also turn this any way I want it. So I've got the ultimate in capabilities as far as setting it up somewhere and trying to get the very best picture I can with it. Remember, if you have a fixed position right here and it's mounted solid to your boat, you can't adjust it this way, okay? You probably can go around and around with it, but you can't adjust it back and forth like this. I can because a magnet will sit here and it'll rotate like that. And then I can also adjust, pull it out of the water and adjust this to wherever I want it, okay? That's important, really, really important, because it really makes your LIVESCOPE unit a lot more efficient. So come over here, now that you've heard the beginning of the story, come over here with me. Hey, come on, get up here. Stay. And I don't know how I ended up doing this with the dog in the house, but like I said, I really like to have some things with me when I go down to the dock, okay? This isn't as important when I go down on a boat, but one of the things I have noticed is I've blown a couple fuses, either of the power supply or the GLS-10 fuse. If you're going to make a portable unit, you're going to put a little battery in it, get you some extra fuses. I got the bubblegum lure flavor. I'll just pack it around with me. I got my scissors. Okay, I got my scissors, my hook remover, and just a little bunch, little crappie kickers, go-go minnows, big eye jig heads. Just stuff that I use down on the dock. Really simple, and it's light. And I can carry it all with me at the same time, so I don't have to have tackle box, which to me was an important deal, and to me, one of the reasons why I chose this big Plano box. Now, I don't know if I've got a number on the Plano box here, but it's just a big orange Plano box system. I don't see a number on it anywhere. Okay, so I mounted my 7-inch unit up on top right here, okay? I put a couple screws in this compartment to hold it down because I didn't want my unit to flip up back and forth, flip back and forth. So I put a couple screws in here to hold down my 7-inch unit. So now I can flip it over, get into my box, and I've got all my extra cable right here for my transducer. If you look in here, I mounted my GLS-10 box against the side wall of the orange box, okay? So I've used a couple small bolts. I've double nutted these in hopes that they wouldn't get loose and this thing wouldn't back off. And I've got all my power cord, my fuses, everything ran to my little Dakota Lithium battery, okay? And then I run my power cord and my GLS-10 stuff. This goes to my transducer. This is going to come up and go to the 7-inch unit echo map. This is going to come up and go to the 7-inch echo map. All of my adapters and everything I need for my LIVESCOPE box to go to the 7-inch unit are all coiled up nice and neat right here, okay? So remember that on the fuses, all right? So anyway, I just put four bolts in it, double nutted the inside of this, so my GLS-10 box does not get loose. So that is how I put my box together, and that is how I put my LIVESCOPE pole together, my transducer on my pole. Now I want to go outside and I want to show you how I use this on my boat, because you can see how it would be very easy to use this in a dock when you just stick it on a dock somewhere. And the other cool thing about this is you can walk around in a dock looking at your unit like this, and you can see where the active fish or the brush piles are, whatever it is. Maybe there's an old chair or something that fell down in the water, and there might be some crappie or panfish around it. So you can use this as a fish finding tool on a dock, just like we do in the boat. So let's go outside and let's look at the magnet system, the angle iron system on the boat. Okay, so we're on to the boat area. Now, one of the things that I've really enjoyed about using my mobile unit on the boat is I can put my box and my 7-inch unit up here anywhere I want to look at it, okay? It doesn't have to be fixed in one position, so if I've got multiple people out here in the boat with me, I can set the box here, there, there, and I've got plenty of transducer cable to set it in the back of the boat if I want. But this is the magnet system that I have right here. Now, this is an old piece of angle iron, and what I do with this is I just stick my unit to my boat right there, okay? So again, we've got our T-handle, and our T-handle's lined up perfectly with the magnet. So from this point right here, I can take and I can rotate that unit that way to look forward a little bit. I can look backwards with it a little bit. I can look straight down. The transducer right now is set on straight down. I can rotate this to look this way across the front of my boat, which is how I use it a lot, especially if I'm fishing with somebody and we're jigging straight underneath the nose of the boat. I've got the unit shining this way, and I can see my jig over here. Another guy can see his jig over there. I can switch it around to forward view, turn it like this, and now it's shining under my boat this way. I can turn it like this, and it's shining this way. So I've got the ultimate in control. Right now, that would be shining this way, along the edge of my boat, out down that way. And if my picture's not just exactly the way I want it, or I'm having problems seeing it, I'll just roll it up there just a little bit like that, or roll it back just a little bit. So the magnet, even though it's kind of a crude way of doing things, really, to me, gives me the best opportunity to get the most out of my LIVESCOPE system. And I'm gonna continue to use this on lots of different boats. So anyway, I hope this answers a bunch of your questions. It's a very long video, but I just got inundated with questions about how I set this up and about how I use it. This technology's not going anywhere. Lowrance and Humminbird will all probably be coming out with things that are comparable to Garmin LIVESCOPE. But right now, Garmin has got this technology out, and I tell you what, it will definitely make you a better angler, but you got to learn how to use it. It's like everything else. It's not a magic wand or a magic bullet. You got to get out there on the water, and you got to figure out how to make it work for you. So anyway, I'm Jeff with Fle Fly. Make sure you come see us at fleafly.com. We appreciate all of our customers, and we appreciate the support when you guys are buying our fishing tackle. That's what allows me to get out here on the water and do more how-to videos and try to help you guys catch more fish. Thanks for watching.